Morning everyone, it's Dali from Dali Art, and today what have I got for you? Well, I'm going to be doing a orange project, or you could call it autumnal. Basically, I wanted to talk to you all about the competition. And we've got a competition running. We're going to be doing one every month, Pip and I. It's all about the colour orange and leaves. And we've put a special offer together for you with these universal primer, which you can use with any of the crackle pastes, and then the two crackle pastes. So we've got an orange and a green, and they are absolutely beautiful to work with, especially for autumn colours, even for Halloween, all year round. So they are, we've got a special offer on those. They're $9.99, they're 100 mils each. So you get so much. So there you are, those three. So you've got the crackling pastes and you've got the crackle primer. Now, talking about the actual competition, basically you need to put your pictures using orange and leaves onto the actual Facebook page of Dali Art Market and Friends, or Pip Art Creations and Friends. So that is what you need to do so that we can then judge those entries. The winner will receive either £30 in the UK, or euros if they're European, or they'll receive the US dollars? Canadian dollars, I should say, which is $50. So really you've got just what you love to do. We're giving you the opportunity to choose from the colour orange and the leaves theme to make a project. I've got you started, Pip got you started yesterday, and I'm going to go through using orange today. And we really would like to see what you can come up with. Now, you can spend that £30 or those $50 on whatever you like in our stores. So there's no boundaries in terms of what you can select. The whole shop or the whole online website is open to you. So this is a really nice way if you're dipping your toe, or you're somebody who's very creative and wants to have a go and put something forward. So really this is all about us getting involved and being a little bit more creative and allowing people the opportunity to share their work with us. So it's trying to build that community. And so we're just basically going to go through today using the crackle pastes and the crackle primer. So basically what I want to do is show you how these work. It's the same way if you use the white one, but the colours are obviously different, the texture is slightly different, and the consistency is slightly different, purely because of the colours and the pigments that these crackle pastes have. So I think what I'd like to do is get started, and I can talk through the competition throughout the Facebook Live so that you're all a part of it. So let me just get some kitchen roll to get us all started. So what are we doing today? So we're going to create these leaves. That is what we're going to show you, how you create these leaves from this stencil. Now you can see there, that is the orange crackle paste, and it looks like the leaves have got veins and got all this texture going on. So you can just see how beautiful that looks. Now there's an easy way of creating the crackle paste through the stencil that I found was quite easy, in terms of the fact that before we used to always put the primer and the crackle paste, and we used to have to wash the stencil in between and so forth. So I've found a slightly different way of doing it. So let me just show you a couple of techniques. I also wanted to share with you the green. Now can you see, I don't know if you can see the cracks in those, but you can just catch that crack there. Again, I've just done some green ones before I started, so that you could see some in the green as well. So what I want to do is, I want to just take a piece of cardboard or something not too flimsy, not paper, and to get us started. Okay, and then take your stencil. I'm just going to use my used stencil because that's easier. Okay, and you can tape it down if you want to, but you know me, I'll just put it as it is. So that's where you just want to see where you're going to position that roughly, just at this moment in time. Right, now what we need to do is, and this is where it's slightly different to what I've done in the past, is take your crackle primer, which is also a part of that same set. And this is the primer that's used for nearly all of the crackle pastes. Okay, so what we want to do is, let's dry my brush, take a dry brush, and primer down, just lightly, not too much, onto the card. Okay, just straight on. Just as if you were priming a canvas or you were priming it on any other material. So, I mean, you could do this on watercolour paper, you could do this to even give you more texture. I'm just chosen to do this. You could do it on black. You could do it on any colour paper as well. So that's another way to do it. So if you wanted a background to be slightly different. So all I've done is I've just painted that crackle paste, primer, down. Okay, just try and get most of it. I mean, it just means that you need to cover it, but you don't need a thick coat. Okay, so I'm happy with that. Now the next thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to take my heat tool and I'm just going to dry that a little bit. Now that will be slightly tacky, so you know you will have tackiness on that slightly. If you dry it a little bit more thoroughly, obviously that will dry, and you can see where the crackle primer is because it's a little bit shinier. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to take the stencil, just having a look what I want to create, and I'm just going to put that down. Okay, so this is how we would create the orange leaves, the green leaves. So just put that down where you're, I just want to put those two big ones because I like those. There we go. So you could have a bigger piece of paper and obviously you could work around that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a little bit of the green and I'm also going to use the orange. So I'm going to do it. So all you do is, as you would normally, just take your paste and just put it through. Don't worry if it goes through too much, don't worry if it goes through and seeps. It's not a problem, because what we're going to do is we're using these leaves just to cut them out. So I'm going to do a few green ones, I'm going to do a few orange ones, I'm going to do a few of the mixture as well. So there we go. So that's all you're doing, you're just putting it through the stencil like you would with anything else. Right, so then I'm going to use a little bit of the orange. Now the orange, each of them have got slightly different consistencies, so don't worry too much if you find, oh, one's thinner, one's thicker. It really is slightly a different way of doing it. So orange is the theme, so let's get some orange out. So all I'm going to do is, so as you can see, I've got a little bit of green going on in there now, and I've got a little bit of the orange. And I don't mind that because leaves can be green and they can be orange and they can be lots of different shades. So all I'm doing, just want to make sure my palette knife is clean while I'm going into this orange. And all I'm doing is taking some, I'm really at the bottom of this pot now, so bear with me. There we go. And all I'm doing is putting that through. And I'm just showing you that's how I created my background. Using these crackle paste. This is how I start it. There we go. I'm just going to wipe that knife again. So we've got a clean knife. As clean as I can get it. There we go. So what happens now is you need to just put your stencil into water, which is what I'm going to do now. Okay. And it doesn't matter if these are seeped through like that one, it's not a problem at all. Because when that dries, let's look at that. I'm going to crackle those now and then I'll show you. Okay, the boring part, as they say. So now these have actually cracked. I don't know if you can see the crackles there, but these have actually all cracked really beautifully. So what happens now is I just take a pair of scissors, say for example, let's take this little one here, so it's, and you can cut through the paste, so it's not a problem. So you can actually so there we go, sorry, I've just pushed it away from me, there we go. So that then gives you this really nice crackled leaf, and I haven't actually put any wax on it yet or anything to show you the actual beauty of it. I'm just going to cut these through. Very easy to cut, really nice shape. So you can use it as a leaf stencil, but I have used mine a lot more as flowers. So you can see all the crackle there, look. And then what I like to do is, and you can keep going, I mean, even the ones where it's smudged, you get really nice effects. So, you know, just go in and just take those. So, and that's how I created the green ones. That's how I created all of these orange ones. So all I've done is I've gone in and I've created these on a sheet so that we've got all of these so that we can play with them. Then what I do is, I obviously want to change the colour, or I want to change them slightly, and what I need to do is, let me just move these out of the way, so there we go, is that I'm going to use a decor soft, and I'm going to add a little bit of a green to them. So, just clean my brush. You could add some sparkling gel, I'll show you with sparkling gel as well. So you can really do whatever you want. So I've got a bit of decor soft here, and all I want to do is go in and then colour those, and what will happen is you'll get the veins, and then again, you depending on the colours you go for, you can then now smudge that back, and that will go into the veins a bit more, and that will just knock back the colour a little bit more, so you've got something that's quite bright. Now that looks more leaf-like than that does. So it's just trying to get those different effects. Again, you could add a little bit of sparkling gel to that just to give it another look. So let me show you with that. And again, it's a slightly different look, but it gives you this real nice shimmer. So can you see that? So that's dried. That gives you a really nice shimmer. If you want to keep the brightness of this as well, you could go in and you could shimmer it down, and that gives you another look. So you've got already got different shadings there of the leaves. Can you see that sparkle with the sparkling gel? It's the translucent gold. Now today we've got the two crackle paste and the primer only for £9.99 as a special, but can you see how lovely they look? And this is how you start to build your flowers up. And the other thing I really like is the white wax. As you know, I'm a bit addicted to my white wax at the moment. And I find that's a really easy way to add definition. So that's the beautiful finishing waxes. It's a big pot. And I just use my finger. I mean, I don't think this will ever finish in my lifetime. So, and all I'm doing is I'm just coming in with that. And again, it gives you a different look. Each time you do something, it's always a different look. And again, now look at that one. Now what you could do is use your crystal 3D pens and put little raindrops on that, sort of like rain dews or whatever. Now already you've got three different, from just that leaf stencil, you've made some leaves. You can make them into flowers, you can make them into leaves, you can cut into these so that you might want to say, well actually, do you know what, I want to make this more like a poinsettia. So you can just start to cut into these, and you've got a different shape already going on. So you might want to make them look like that at the edges, so like a little heart shape. So again, you can change all of this, and it's really easy. And the crackle effect really makes those veins like come to life a little bit more. That's what I like about it. Right, so today what I was going to show you is how to do this background. So slightly different. This was with the rice paper. So just like I always do with my rice papers. But I thought, you know what, I'd like to build something a little bit different and show you how I did this background using the leaf stencil. Okay, so the way I've done this is that I'll show you what I did so that you've got an idea of how I started it at least. So the first thing to do is, I've just taken a little bit of grey board just to show you. And what I do is I just take the white primer, the Pentart primer. I use my brush as well just to wet everything. So it doesn't matter. Just makes it a little bit easier to move the paint. Now if you don't want to use the white primer, we can also use the Decor Soft. So let's try it with that and see what sort of colours we get with that as well. So all we're doing is we're just covering this grey, just a little bit, not too much. I still like the texture, I still want, and this will all dry obviously. We can even add a little bit of white to it if we want in places. So really what you're doing is you're creating your own backgrounds here with very little product. So you can see already, just on a little bit of cardboard that I've cut out, we're already creating this really lovely background. Got a little bit of gold already there. Okay, just make sure my brush is nice and dry. So what I've done there is I've done a little bit of primer, a little bit of the Decor Soft, and you could use any, I've just used light colours because I want the orange to pop on top of that. Then what I want to do is just give that a quick blast. Already, you know, we've got something that was just a bit of grey card already becoming a little bit more lively. Then what I've done is I've just taken, as all most of us will have, is I've just taken some book pages, and all I've done is just randomly placed them. Doesn't matter how you place them because they're all going to be in the background. So just going to stick those down with some glue. And straight on to the back. So don't worry too much. Don't overthink it. Just have a play. You know, all we're doing is we're just making a little bit of a background here, a little bit of texture for us. And you know, I'm just doing this so that you can have other ideas. So if you haven't got maybe rice papers, or you haven't got backing papers or anything, and you just want to do something from your junk mail, or you know, this is so easy to do. So we've just got a little bit of glue going down. I mean, I'm not using a lot, so I'll turn that one around that way. And all this will do is give some textures in the background. That's all we're doing here, is creating a little bit of texture in the background. And if you feel that you need to do another coating over it, just coat it with your glue. But what we're going to do is we're going to put the primer over the top anyway. Okay, and so that way we've got that there. So that's your, that's like your first base down already. Then the next bit, I'm just going to dry that quickly. I'm just looking at some of these words, and I'm happy that I will be covering them. So the next thing I did was I actually then took my, obviously you need your stencil back again, so I just need to dry my stencil, which is nice and colourful now. And I'm just going to do that. Give me 1 second. So let me just put that back down. I've already put it into water, so it's really easy to clean. These stencils are, you know, 300 mylar. And all you do is just put them into a bit of water. Obviously at home you take your time a little bit, get your scrubber out if you wanted to, but they really don't ruin at all. And that's all I've done was, when we used it earlier, is just put it into a bit of water. I mean, obviously at home, please take your time, clean it up properly and so forth. Okay, so but this just shows you how easy. They're not brittle, they're really easy to keep clean. And they're really good for embossing with as well. So you can do lots of techniques. Okay, so I'm going to show you the same technique or how I did the back. So what did we start off with? We started off with the crackle primer. Get the primer rather than the paste. 1 second, there we go. So I started off with the crackle primer. So that's exactly what I'm going to do again. I'm just going to use that to do the background. Alright, I'm just getting my brush. So I hope you'll all be entering the orange competition, because like I say, you have the opportunity to win £30 and spend that in the shop on whatever you want, or $50 Canadian in Canada. And it all you have to do is post your pictures to Dali Art Market and Friends, or Pip Art Creations and Friends. So That's what we're asking, just one entry, and it would be lovely to see what you do with the colour orange. So all I'm doing is the same technique, putting a little bit of that primer down like I did to show you when I first did the one that I did earlier, this one. So very, very similar, okay? So I really love this technique, because what you can now do by doing it this way is that you can now dry it. And you're not getting your stencil dirty twice. So that I found this was a really good way of doing it. So now I've got this background, I can now come in with my stencil. And I can just go wherever I want to. If I want to go at an angle, or if I just want to do half of it, then I can do that. And you know what, I might, I want to do it different to the other one. I always want to do something different, don't I? So I'm going to actually put my leaves, I'm going to put them like this on this side, because I can. And it doesn't matter if this is all sticky, it really doesn't matter. So I'm going back into my green. There we go, taking that, and obviously you could hold this down, and then if you did that you wouldn't get any seepage through the back, but I like, as you all know, I like to be dangerous. So all I'm doing is just covering that back of that. So we've already put the primer down, so this will all crackle on top. If you don't want to cover all the leaves, or you want to do parts of them, then that's okay as well. We don't have to cover the whole background. I'm just showing you different ways of doing this. A lot of people just do this once and then they take the excess off. I'm a bit of a mixture. I do it once, sometimes I don't, you know, I do it in lots of different goes. Sometimes I lift it like this, because if you have a look now, you'll get these like leaf-like, and then you'll get the crackle as well. Let's try that, because I've not done that on the other one. So let's try that as well, because let's live daringly. But that again will give us more texture. It won't stop it from crackling. Do this big one down here, and we're nearly done. So, you know, it's just a different way of doing things. By moving your stencil, you get a different design. By using your palette knife and putting it down and lifting it, you get different effects. So, you know, we're going to get lots of, you know, different effects. And nothing has to be perfect, because that's the whole idea of mixed media, is that nothing is perfect. So I'm just doing it like this. So you've got like a stippled effect with crackle. So there we go. So then just put all the excess back in. Okay. And then I'm just going to put the palette knife and my stencil straight into water. And there you go. And you've got this beautiful imprint underneath. Okay, so you've already got quite a nice texture already going on there with the stippling. Now we're just going to dry that to crackle. Now that has so much definition. Hopefully I can pick that up for you. There you go. So you can just see how that's crackled. And just look at all that effect, and it's still cracking away. And then you've got also the stippling effect. So you've got a lot of texture going on in there. Okay, so you would actually thoroughly dry it, obviously. Really, really dry it. And then what I'm going to do is I'm coming in with the orange Lazur, loved as you can see. And I'm just going to pour it on there. There we go. I'm daring. So then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take that, and then I'm just going to take my brush, and I really want to create that background with the bright orange. And can you see how this Lazur just creates that beautiful, beautiful background? And now you can see how that's going into the leaves, how that's all being picked up. You don't need a lot. And we sell 8 of these for only £13.50. It's a bit of a bargain, really. But they are absolutely beautiful to work with. And I know a lot of you have these, so, you know, do use them. And I just put it straight on. You could put it onto your mat and use it that way so you have more control. You could leave it. But there's that bright orange we're talking about for the competition there in the background already. And then what we're going to do is, we're just going to, so it's, the paper's given it a little bit of definition, it's also given it a bit of depth. So you're getting all these different little bits in the background that's really working for you. And all this was a little bit of cardboard, or a little bit of grey board, or whatever you want to call it. And all we've done is just built around it. So already you've got now this really nice bit of mixed media going on in the background. And you can start to lift a little bit where you want to. So you've got a little bit more texture going on there. Also helps me dry it a bit faster. Okay. So then what I'm going to do is I use that decal paint at the beginning. And I'm going to bring that in. Just going to give it a blast of dry. And there's several ways of creating a sort of the metallic look that I've created here in the background. You could just use waxes. You could use the sparkling mediums. So there's lots of different ways of doing it. One of the ways I've decided to do it was that I wanted to use a little bit of a script stamp, which is one of the Stamperia stamps. I'm just using a distress ink, just black. And I just want to create a little bit of the background so that we're breaking up these bits and we're just putting that down. There we go. So not too much, but just enough. And again, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take little bits of that script stamp and I'm just using the black ink. It'll stay wet long enough for me to apply a little bit of the embossing powders. I don't want too much, so I don't want it to be wet everywhere, but that'll give you an idea. So now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take the Dali Art embossing powder and I'm going to throw that at that. Now you could use a Versamark here. You could use lots of different things. So I've chosen just to do it with a little bit of a wet ink. Hopefully wherever it's wet still, it will capture it. So I don't want too much. I don't want my whole piece to be gold on this occasion. So just tap all that off. Okay, so you've got little bits and I can see that I've got little bits going on there. And that's enough for me. So put that back in our little pot. Obviously, we use this a lot. And I find that as long as your ink is wet, you don't need a Versamark to do your stamping. But obviously, if it's not, then you Versamark is the way forward. Home, please take your time. Obviously, you know, don't worry too much. So we've got more and more texture going on there. So can you now see how that just catches bits of it but not all of it? And that's exactly what I wanted. If you feel you've missed some, just go back in with your heat gun and you'll capture it. There you go. Okay, so that is the beauty, and this also acts as a resist as well, so it's a really nice way to work. Now I'm going to come in with my Decal Soft again. The one I keep using, so a lot of people ask me, is Lichen Green. I really like, well actually I like all the Decal Softs by Pentart, but this is one of my favourites. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to knock that back still a little bit further. Not much, but just enough. Just knocking it back a little bit. Again, dry brushing it on, and my brush is a little bit wet, but just dry brush it on, and what it will do is it will just give you more character to your work. Again, it's just about building those layers up. Okay, you want a bit more, then just bring in a bit more. And the thing with the embossing folders is if you now took a baby wipe over any of those or a wet cloth, you would then get a really, you would still get your leaves showing through. So you could easily get a little bit more of your leaves showing through. So that's one thing I wanted to show you. So if you added more embossing powder and more of the DecoSoft, then you could go a little bit darker into it as well. Now I'm going to still build onto this. So what I'm doing now is I'm going to bring in the white wax, which I absolutely love. So I'm going to do this. I'm just going to use my brush. And I'm just going to take a little bit of that with my brush. And all I'm doing is I'm just bringing it in. And what this will do, because the wax is a much softer than paint is, then what you can do is you can really, really go in and start to highlight bits if you want to. Not too much, because you want to keep it. Now don't worry if you think, oh gosh, I've just gone too white with or more, or anything like that. Because what we're going to do is we'll heat that a little bit, rub that all back, and what this will give us is another dimension. And I love the white wax, because everywhere you put it, it gives you such a highlighted piece. And again, you know, just go in. You can do it with your fingers, you can do it with a brush. And we have this in three colours. And I know a lot of you are waiting for this in Canada, and it is on its way, hopefully, by the end of this week, because we were out of the brown, and that's just coming in from Pentart. So, once you've done that, what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to take the heat gun first. That's just melted it down a little bit. I feel like I need a little bit of white in the middles as well. Just put a little bit, otherwise it looks like I've just put it all on the edges. Okay. Right, so then what I'm going to do is I'm going to just take a little bit of kitchen roll. There we go. And I'm just going to come in. I'm just going to polish that up a little bit. Don't have to do it a lot. But what it'll do is it'll just take away a little bit of the whiteness, but also make it a little bit more subtle in the background as well. And this is what I love about the waxes. Now, you can't get this with the white primer. So, and that will just give me just enough to break that background up. So now you can see how nice and subtle that looks, how lovely that looks. And then what I did was I took the, from the Stamperia stamp set, it's a really, really beautiful one. Let me put this way. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to stamp that just to show you how beautifully it stamps, but also how nice it, put it the right way, Dalvinda. So I'm just going to, doesn't matter because I'm going to cut it out anyway. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to use the verse mark this time because I don't want to make it all black. And all I'm going to do is just take that and just put that down. Okay. And what that does is I'm just going to stamp that in the corner here so then I can cut it out. Just press down. There we go. And that becomes like a sticky, it's like a sticky glue pad really. That's the best way to describe it. So always wipe your stamps afterwards with a baby wipe or some wet water, whatever you've got at hand. And I did the same with the beautiful bonheur. So we've got those, and we've got quite a lot, and that's what the script stamps from as well. So it's a quite a big stamp set. I think that's WTKCC113. I know a few of you like this stamp. Okay, you get butterflies. I should show you really, shouldn't I? I've got loads of it. You've got butterflies, you've got music, you've got Marseille, you've got this lovely little border, then you've got the big flower, the script. So there's a lot on that stamp, I have to say. lots. So before this dries, let me put some of this embossing powder. So this will bring it back to where I was originally. So let me put that on there. And then what I usually do is just trickle that down. And I find if I work on smooth cardstock, I find that it doesn't actually stick to the card. I find I get less static. So that's all I've done, is just put some embossing powder on that. I'm going to open a new one, I think, of that, Dalvinda. So, again, we just need to dry that, or heat emboss it, I should say. This technique will always be magical. I don't think it'll ever change. And then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to cut this one out. So just always find that if I cut the bigger piece out first, then I can go in very easily. And obviously at home, take your time and do this. And all I'm doing is I'm just cutting around the lines already there. So it's really easy to do, very easy to follow, and the embossed lines really allow your inks to stay within those lines. It's such a nice way to use your stamps and to get this real nice sort of metallic nearly finish on the edges. I just love it, and it's a good way if you're using alcohol inks or anything, or alcohol pens, to emboss your images, and that way you've not got any issues with the colours running, the you know, anything going wrong really, that would go wrong usually with the bleed or anything like that. So just very quickly, I've just cut that down. There we go. So that's quite simple. Quite easy to do. Then what I thought was, is I've used the Lazor, so I need to, I've decided I'm going to colour with Lazor as well. So, there we go. Just wipe my brush. So I've got a clean brush. This is the one I've used for the wax, so you can see how easy it is to use. And this time I'm not going to throw it on there, so I'm just going to put a little bit on there. I always wipe, or I try to wipe the edges off. So, very easy. Just put it straight on. Look at that. I mean, it's just so easy, the Lazors, to work with. And it goes right to the edges. It really does work really, really well. A few flowers here. So, oh, you could leave it in its how it was. You could add a little bit more colour. So you could shade it a little bit more, come back in again, dry it. Add some more sort of oranges, maybe even do them a different colour. But as orange is our theme, so all I'm going to do now is I'm just going to add a little bit of the green as well. It's easier for my lids. There we go. And I'm just going to do the leaves now. And again, using the same brush, Dali never changes. So you can easily go in and really make that how you want it. Okay, so even if you want to come in, do a little bit more here, a little bit more here in the greens, a little bit there, even here. So it just brings it all together. Side. And you can always bring the orange in just to break it down a bit into the brownie. So you can add a little bit more colour to your leaves. So you can just come in, lift it out, and it's like a watercolour, it's a stain actually. So, and then you can just come in, because you've got a bit of green on there, and then you can come in just a little bit. It's a really easy way, if you struggle to paint or anything, really nice way to give you a really lovely, look at that, look how beautiful that looks. You can just see that. And look how easy that was. All I did was cut it, and that's what I did. So I'm going to just use, I've already done this, they stamped the word as well. I just use the green to edge it. And these are really good for edging, great for splashes. So if you're looking at doing splashes or something with the... Let's wipe that down a little bit for us. All water-based, they're really easy to use. So let's go back to where we were with our card or our tag. We'll use this one as we've been working on this one. We can use the other one if we want. So what I've got is I already started to paint, and now I've already changed those two a little bit. So different colours slightly, one's darker, one's lighter. And what we can do is we can either decoupage those up, so you've got even more definition, or I'm going to stagger them onto my picture. So that I've got little bits over here, a little bit over there. So I want to sort of frame them a little bit more. And if you want a little bit more orange in it, you can go in with a little bit more orange. And so we can start to sort of build this little display up. So now look at that. It's already really, really lovely. And then what we can start to do is remember these leaves. And if you look on this one, they're a little bit darker. All I've done, so that you know, is I've gone in and I've taken a black soot and I've just basically lifted those again where the crackle is. And I really like this effect. And already, they already look, whoops, so much different. So much different, is that even a word? So different, I should say. So I'm going to see where we can fit all these in now that we've cut them. There we go. So lots of different shadings. Use it as a background. Use it to create flowers. Use it to create hearts. I mean, really, you can do so much with this stencil. It's unbelievable. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to colour that a little bit more black. So we've got a bit more edging on it. And this is the beauty of the embossing powders. Is that you can really go to town because they keep that edge for you, and you can always wipe it if you get too much of anything on them or too little. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start to bring that in as well onto the edges. So that gives you that background. And again, just go in and it'll just catch wherever there is a little bit to catch. Okay, there we go. So that's just using the black distress. And then what I want to do is I want to start to build my picture in here. So you've got, you could use three. I've only done two, but you could use three. So you've got all of these that can now, you're starting to make this really lovely tag. And if you wanted to whitewash a little bit more in the background, you could. So this is how I do my, flowers as well. So you can just see that it's so easy, even if you just put three there. You've got this really lovely corner already. And you can use a glue gun, you can use you can use whatever you like. And if you just want to tuck a few of these over here, let me take a bit of the orange ones. It's just showing you a few ideas of what you can do with just a little, just some colour, some stencil. And so can you now see how that's all coming together? Move that one up a bit. And again, you can come in, you can put more writing onto them, you can add more colour to them. So, you might say, oh, well, actually, it would be really nice maybe to have a green one behind it now. So you can see, look, how you can start using just those leaves, because they're all different sizes. Start to bring that in. Right, I'm going to just stick that down. And I know my glue gun is off, so bear with, because I'm going to just use a heavy body mat for now. I know that's not the answer. Well, it is the long term, but not short term. So all I'm going to do is I'm just going to put this down, because I want to put my splashes in. This will dry over time anyway. So all I'm doing is just putting those two bits down. And I will have to let this dry. So I'm going to put a little bit in the middle there. And again, so you're just putting these all in, and this will all dry, and so you'll see it all. And I'll post some pictures of this as well. So this is just one take of how we can do it. So don't worry about the glue; that'll all dry. It's just the heavy body. And this is quite a good one to use because now they won't go anywhere. You can shape these. So, and again, you can decoupage more of these up. So all I'm doing, I'm going to leave those now because I need to get my glue gun to heat up. But I just want to show you, that's where we've got to so far. And then what I want to do is I've used the texture spray. It's the media texture spray, the white. And I'm just going to create some splashes without harming everything that I've got. Paul's bought me a new clock, which is really, oh, I'll show you actually, because it's so funky, look. What a funky clock. It is so funky. So, I better cover it, because I'll end up ruining it otherwise. We'll try and cover it. So, and all I do is I'm going to take some of these and do some splashes. Don't worry if they're too big, they're too small. It all is just a part. If you find they're too big for you or anything like that, just go back in and just wipe them while they're still wet. So this is a really nice way. You can control it a little bit better. I mean, I just like this look. And these will dry like a 3D. So they won't dry just as a flat. And that's what I like about these. The texture sprays. And I find they're easier to use like this than they are to spray, because they are really, really thick. Is you can easily go in and do some splatters. And if you wanted to, you can just add a little bit. And what this will do is it does actually create like an acrylic 3D finish. So let's just stick everything down. We haven't stuck any of those down, she says, moving them. So you've got an idea there where we're going with that. And then finally, what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a few of my orange splashes, as it's an orange competition. So we couldn't be without orange splashes. So just take a little bit. And this is the beauty of the Lazores, is they do splash really, really well. And you'll see already, add a little bit more there, to add to my splashes. And again, little more, it's up to you. As well, obviously I get carried away. And then if you want to, you can start bringing a little bit more of the red into there, or the orange, sorry, and diluting that down. But just be careful, because obviously if you've got colour behind it and it's water-based like the big thing, you will get this black thing. And that's okay, because I'm going to show you how to fix that. So what you do, I'm just going to wipe that away, is that will still move. Just wipe it while it's still wet, because the texture spray is still underneath. Actually, I quite like that. Let me move that back in. Let's add a little bit more of the orange here. There we go. There we are. Quite happy with that now. So you can just see that you can actually really, really go to town. And if you wanted to, you could just use a lid and put some bits of orange into this. Just break it up a little bit more. And it really is your project. So whatever you do with it, it doesn't matter. It's just a bit of cardboard. I just wanted to give you some inspiration for the orange competition, and hopefully that you will join. Let me just wipe my little bit of mess up that I've seems to have made. Let's put this, clean this up and show you. Whoops. Oh, look, they've all come off, the little ones, because they weren't stuck on. But I'll stick those down again for you to have a look at. Okay, let's stick those back down again. Well, I'm not stick them down, hold them down again. So there we go. It's not a big problem. We can do that. I'm going to change it because I liked it the way it was. There we go. So you've got all the different sizes in the stencil. So this really works well. There you go. So now you can see already how lovely that looks. Whoops. See? It's a really, and obviously you can add more colour to that. You can do a slightly different take on that. You've got this one here as well. So, you know, again, you can see how different they all look. You've got this one here. So there we go, let's push them all up. So you've got all of these different varieties. You know, you might just want to stick a butterfly on the middle of it. You know? So you can do so many different things with just so little. And these are just so nice, the crackle pastes. Because if you look at that green, if you can just look at that. And if I add a little bit of orange to that, it just gives it a different, different feel. And it's so easy. So you can just see how that's just sunk into there. Add a little bit of brown to it maybe. So you can change your colour of your leaves, and the crackle just really lends really well to this. This could be a more of a darker brown. And again, you can see already how I'm changing that leaf from where, oops, from where we started being quite harsh and white. And then what we can do is we can add, you know, other bits to it. You know, a little bit of, like I've said, the sparkling gel. There's just so much. And nothing takes away from them because you've got all the crackle there, you've got everything. Just all you need to do is, while it's still a little bit wet, is just rub that back a little bit. Let's take a little bit of kitchen roll and just rub it back a little bit. And I just love what you can do. Just imagine making these for your Christmas cards, just on white. So, you know, if you just had a bit of white card, I'll just show you. Look how lovely they look. Can you see that? And the glimmer and the actual crackle on those. It's just so pretty. So hopefully that's given you a little bit. Maybe I could tuck that one in there now because I like it so much. Oh, look. Isn't that lovely? Maybe move that. So it's good reasons to do your waxes. And maybe put that one up there again. There you go. So you can do, look, don't waste anything. So you can just do that. So there's some ideas for you, a background I've created, and a couple of tags. So, whoops. So I hope you've enjoyed it as much as I do doing these. And I hope you enter the competition. And we look forward to seeing your entries and announcing the lucky £30 winner or the $50 winner. So Pip Art Creations and Friends and Dali Art Market and Friends. So all you need to do is go onto our Facebook, post some of these pictures, and we're away. So thank you very much for watching once again. Don't forget to watch my show at 4 o'clock tomorrow for Dali TV. Got lots of offers. Don't forget, you've got this great offer on these three crackle paste plus the crackle primer for just $9.99 as a part of this Facebook Live. So thank you so much. Lots of orange inspiration and leaves for you. So take care. See you tomorrow. Bye.